last Saturday, this package arrived for me. Finally arrived for me, I should say. It only took 10, maybe 12 weeks to get here. It was held up by customs, and they wanted some sort of contribution for the racket they run. And then there was an issue with my address details, which is kind of weird, because eBay does have my correct address details. They prove that all the time. But I'm not complaining. It's not like I run a 24/7 workshop over here, nor was I anxiously waiting for the postman every day, like the neighbor's dog. So what we got here is a little frequency drive. It actually looks a lot like the other one that I reviewed for a Banggood. And I got my generous PayPal donors to thank for this. I guess they had enough of my constant noise torture with the 32-year-old Allen Bradley frequency drive. It takes a while for your ears to get used to it, but it's not too bad, I think. But you can always dial down the volume or go watch something else. I do feel a bit guilty for torturing you guys into giving me money, so I have removed the PayPal donate button and put up a couple of affiliated links to eBay and Amazon on the channel homepage. In the future, I hope to make some more money with all the crap you guys buy. I guess I wasn't really comfortable with the donate button. If I wanted donations, I could start a Patreon account. At least then the viewer might get something in return. No worries, not thinking about that for now. Besides, I'm not Oxfam NoFip, and I don't have any questionable parties to finance. So let's install this. Hopefully it didn't die during shipping. But before I start doing that, let's start the old Allen Bradley drive one more time to give it a proper send-off. And before it starts working, we will have to wait a minute till we hear some relays clicking. After that, it is ready to go. There it was. I guess that took about a minute. If you don't wait too long on the next power cycle, it'll start working sooner. And it's basically the same with the drives on my wood lathe and drill press. Still, I must say that after 32 years, this is pretty impressive. My hat's off to Allen Bradley. And their lovely noise. All right, time to go dark. Installed. And if you have never installed a frequency drive, it really is very simple. You got your power coming in, single phase with the ground, and this is the power out to the motor. The three phases and also a ground. If the motor runs in the wrong direction, just switch one of these around. It really is very simple. Even a half-wit like me can do it. And I expect the default out-of-the-box configuration will just work fine for most of the situations. Unless you want to do something fancy here to control the frequency drive, it really should be no problem. But don't install it like this. That's a bit of a mess. I guess using Chinese equipment made me a bit lax when it comes to installation standards. But I guess there is also the possibility that I will need to reinstall the Allen Bradley drive if this one turns out to be a DOA. Or maybe I just bring back the Allen Bradley drive to start torturing again. Just kidding. Or am I? And I guess now it's time to find out what this one sounds like. And remember, unlike that 3/4 kilowatt drive, this one has one of those noisy fans. I'm just hoping it will only run when the lathe is running. Here we go. Well, at least it's alive. That's a good thing. I guess I should put some oil in the bearings first. Of course, I need to fill my oil can. A word of warning, while I fill the oil can, don't unscrew the clamps too much. If you do, before you know it, you'll be taking the VFD back off the wall and shaking it around to get the screw back. Run! Wonderful! Thank God, it switched off. With the other Chinese drive I had on this lathe, the Nflix and NF9000, that died with a flash and a bang before I had to reinstall the Allen Bradley, it kept running the fan all the time, and it was annoying. It still might if it gets a bit warm, but for now this sounds good. And it even runs in the right direction. By the way, I probably killed that NF9000 drive by taking out the connector that goes to the fan. Eh, shit happens, I guess. It might sound even better if I increase the carrier frequency a bit. But to be honest, I think this is pretty nice. It runs 5 hertz quicker as default. I think I'll leave it like that. I'm not going to bother reading the user manual again, which by the way is exactly the same as the other drive. It's pretty much the same drive, I think. The case is a little deeper because of the larger heatsink, and this one has a display you can take out that comes with a cable. Some drives do not even have a extra cable. I bet you guys like that noise a whole lot better than the screaming Allen Bradley. Though you really must respect the Allen Bradley, it survived 32 years, and that's a long time for a piece of electronics. A little warning, there is a good chance you will hear the old Allen Bradley drive again, because I got some unfinished videos from a couple of months ago that I really should finish one day. The noise of that little fan isn't too bad. I don't think I will need to do anything about it. I don't remember how the NF9000 sounded, but I'm pretty sure it was worse than this. When it gets a little hotter in here, or when the drive warms up, it might keep spinning longer, but I might look into replacing it with a bigger one from an old computer or something like that. So I guess I'm pretty much done now. That was a quick thank you video for the people who made this possible. So thanks for your donations. Without it, I would still use the old Allen Bradley drive, probably till eternally, because I got a couple of spare ones and they are pretty hard to kill. If you want to donate to replace the other two drives, that's too bad. The donate button is gone. You should just buy a shitload of crap through my affiliated links. That's it for me. Till next time, when I actually might do something useful. Bye for now. One question though, did anyone notice this video was uploaded in a lower resolution than normal? It saved me some time and it's just a little easier on my old computer and limited bandwidth. Thank you.